think we owe it to football ourselves, and we owe it to the players that we're working with, you know, day in and day out, to allow them to enjoy their football and go and do the things that they enjoy. Every player likes to pass the ball and stick the ball in the back of the net in a certain way. And that's what we work for here.
I like to try and produce teams to play the way I would like to watch if I was a spectator. Teams that are attractive but productive. I mean, I love football with a high skill level, you know, where people are not afraid to do a trick and produce flair and things like that.
The two managers involved in this fifth round FA Cup tie here today, Swindon Town against Aston Villa. It's the first time our cameras have ever been here for a live match, and consequently we've made the local headlines today. Of course, there are two other ties around, and at half-time here we'll have highlights from Ipswich against Liverpool, that kicked off earlier, and we'll have the story of Bolton versus Southampton as well, followed by the draw live for the sixth round. Jimmy here, Alan Hansen here. Looking forward to this one, Jim. What do you feel about it?
Looking forward to it very much. It's a perfectly balanced game, although you've got a potential Premier League side against one of the others, as it were. But cup tie football is so different, which means explains a bit why so many lower division teams are still in the draw. Mm-hmm. Because the better players are more consistent. 7 times out of 8, they'll produce the skill that they're looking for. Whereas those lower down will do it 4 or 5 times out of 8. And it's just the difference in class. But on one day, it doesn't matter.
Any hunch today?
Well, Swindon have only lost 3 matches here this season. They're not used to losing at home. And Aston Villa in the first division at the moment, I mean, can be beaten. So perfectly poised. I'm not going to guess. I'll leave it to my good friend on the left.
Well, you've seen Swindon. You've seen Swindon a few times. They get a good press about their football. Is that justified?
Yeah, they try and play football, and they certainly are good to watch. They've got a 5-man defence and they try and push the fullbacks forward. They've got good touch players in the middle of the park and Ling and Hazard, and of course they've got a prolific goal scorer up front in Shearer. There's one or two things that might go against them. One, because they try and play football, the game's liable to be open, and I think that will suit Villa. And two, when I watch them play, they try and play it out of defence. There's nothing wrong with that, but when you do it, you've got to be spot on. And I just felt that they gave the opposition one or two snatches of the ball, and I thought then that they might pay for it eventually. The game is evenly poised, but I just feel that if Villa play well, they'll win the game.
OK. Well, we had a sleet storm about half an hour ago, but now the weather seems to be perfect, so let's enjoy the match. And our commentator is John Motson.
Thanks very much, Des. And we wait for the two teams who are on their way now. And a good reception from an all-ticket capacity crowd of 16,500 here at the county ground. And according to FA rules, 25% of those tickets go to the visitors. So Aston Villa have around 4,000 fans here. And they will remember that on their last visit to Swindon in 1988, Villa clinched promotion back to the First Division under Graham Taylor, now the England manager. The game was a 0-0 draw, and today there's only one survivor on the pitch from that last meeting, and there he is, 27-year-old Colin Calderwood, the Swindon captain, who's been here since the club's fourth division days and who last week scored both goals from centre-back against Brighton. But the real goal machine here at Swindon is 29-year-old Duncan Shearer, who'll be on the lookout today for his 29th goal of the season. So we can take a check on the Swindon team. Their left-back, number 3, Paul Bodin, has just returned to Swindon from Crystal Palace. Number 7, Mick Hazard, played in the cup final for Spurs against QPR 10 years ago, when the winning goal came from the Swindon player-manager Glenn Hoddle, who's injured at the moment. And so when we look at the Swindon formation, you'll see that his normal sweeper's role is taken up by number 10, Ross McLaren, who himself passed a fitness test on a stomach injury. Shearer's partner up front, also a former Chelsea player, is David Mitchell. He's an Australian international. Well, now Aston Villa, who have their own League of Nations, of course, and two of them back today. Number 2, Darius Kubicki, the Pole, he's in the side. And so now is Dwight Yorke, who missed last week's match with injury. He's at number 8. And they'll look to his pace, Aston Villa, because their formation shows Yorke expected to play up front with Regis, which gives them 2 wide men, 18-year-old Steve Froggatt on the left, and on the right, number 7, Tony Daly, who'll be looking for a personal performance to enhance his England claims this coming week. Well, Trevor Brookings with me. I don't know what you make of the conditions here. We had sleet, snow, rain and sunshine this morning.
Yes, as you say, it has been everything. I think it definitely is better than yesterday, when I think most sides did struggle with the wind, the strong wind. It is a fairly brisk breeze blowing down, in fact, from the end where Swindon are kicking in at the moment from left to right. But I would have said that more than anything that the wet weather would have helped it, because when you used to play myself, I loved a zippy top, and with the conditions, it will zip across the surface. And I think with both sides liking to pass the ball, it will favour that style. And so I'm looking forward to an open game, and we might get one of our live games with a few goals, I think.
Well, those two young men will not forget this day. Nine-year-old Stephen Brown with the fair hair and Gavin Bailey, the two mascots. And as Ray Lewis welcomes them and the two captains, there's the Aston Villa manager, who's been a winner at Wembley twice with Manchester United, once with Sheffield Wednesday in the League Cup, and Andy Gray, who played in the winning Everton side in the 1984 FA Cup final. So plenty of Wembley pedigree down there on the Villa bench. And referee Ray Lewis from Surrey. It's now a quite beautiful afternoon here. Glenn Hoddle has appealed to the fans at Swindon for rather more vocal backing in his programme notes. He wants to whip up the atmosphere down here at the county ground, and they've certainly got the chance to do that today. It's a great opportunity for Swindon Town, whose players you'll get used to as we open up the commentary. Not as familiar, of course, as the Aston Villa lads, but Swindon, all in red, will play from right to left in the first half. Aston Villa, white shirts, blue shorts. And this is Mick Hazard, who you will know, to number nine, Tom Jones. And already Kerslake, the right back, starts to charge down the wing. That's the way they play here, with the two fullbacks pushing up all the time. Kerslake is number two. Cyril Regis there for Villa. Gary Parker through to Yorke. Hazard. Jones. Play on. It was Martin Ling who went down, and Parker for Villa. Mitchell for Swindon. Got it back to number 10, Ross McLaren, the spare man. Forward there by Taylor, and there goes Mitchell, knocked over by Paul McGrath. And a free kick for Swindon in a dangerous area in the opening minutes. They've pushed Calderwood and Taylor up on the far side. Calderwood is a real threat at set plays, the centre half. But there are four players waiting to come in, as you can see. Hazard may have something to do with this. This is Tom Jones with the shot, and it deflects away to the far side, but I think there's probably a throw-in given. Here's Jones. Jones again, number nine. Aston Villa have put out the holders, Tottenham Hotspur, and then had a 4-3 win at Derby. But this may be a different sort of test against a team who, as we've said, like to pass the ball around, Glenn Hoddle's side. And the Swindon manager takes a seat upstairs in the first half. And well protected against the wind. Kubicki. Sean Teal for Aston Villa. Hardly been in the Swindon half yet. Here's Parker, and he won't get there now either. Ling. Shearer's gone to the left, Mitchell to the right. Here's Shearer. Hazard. Ling. Bowden's well forward here. Number three, here he is. Ling. Jones. Hazard. Oh, well played by Mick Hazard. And he's going to get the corner, is he? Well stopped by Les Seeley. Seeley's kept Nigel Spink out the Villa goal now since, well, I think it was back in October that he took over. On by Shearer, here's Ling. Takes on Kubicki. It's still Ling. Kubicki held him off for a while. Kerslake's coming up now on the right. Still Kerslake. Jones!
Well, David Kerslake did brilliantly out wide there. I mean, to go past two people, that is what he and Bowden are excellent at. Tight in the corner, he makes the opening, pulls it back, and really a snatch volley from Jones, but it would have been past Seeley before he would have been able to react. A great move, and I'm sure that's lifted the home crowd.
That was Mitchell looking for Hazard on the far side. There was some good defensive play by Ling there for Swindon that really cleared that danger. But this is Parker for Aston Villa with Froggatt outside him. Forward run in the centre by Kevin Richardson into the penalty area. Still Parker. It's come to Daly. And he brings a save out of Nicky Hammond, Tony Daly. Hazard. By Ling, he's found Shearer. Now they've got Jones in the middle and Mitchell, and it was Staunton, a very firm piece of defending because there were two Swindon players coming in on his blind side, Steve Staunton. And Ling again very involved in the Swindon attack. McLaren. Swindon playing some progressive football, Trevor. Bobble on the pitch confused Sean Teal. And with 20 minutes gone and no score, it's Hazard for Swindon. Bowden. Good-looking ball. That's Mitchell. He's on here. It's Mitchell for Swindon. Good save by Les Seeley. Gets all the marks there, the Villa goalkeeper. And David Mitchell knows it's a chance missed. He was clear, there was no flag, and he was right in on the goalkeeper. Seeley, very good in the one-against-one position, Trevor, and my goodness me, he saved Villa there.
Well, they had a goal written all over it, didn't it? They caught flat, Villa trying to play the offside. Tries to be a bit precise with his right foot, but Les Seeley did extremely well, spread himself. One of those preps afterwards you can say, could he have lifted it over him?
Here comes Swindon again. This is Jones. Ling! But the cover is on from McLaren. Making space again. McLaren comes forward, finds Bowden. And Mitchell makes his run again, and again he's onside. They've got Ling and Shearer waiting in the centre here, Swindon. Jones is another alternative, and so is Hazard here. And it hits it, and it's Ling! And Seeley saves the second one. The defender blocked the first. Exciting stuff again from Swindon Town. Mitchell timed his run beautifully there and opened up the whole game. Mick Hazard drove the first shot, back off the defender. Martin Ling curled the second, Seeley was there. At the moment, Swindon are coping very comfortably back there. That was Mitchell. Play on, says Ray Lewis. This is Ling. He's got Shearer to his right. And he really goes at them, this lad, from midfield. And can Shearer reach it? He can, and it goes fizzing across the six-yard box. Mitchell couldn't get there, but another
really dangerous attack by Swindon, and well initiated again by Martin Ling. Here's Bowden. And now Daly, Yorke. To Staunton. And there goes Regis, and Nicky Hammond out quickly.
Certainly it was a great ball from Martin Ling here. You see, he's knocked Shearer out wide across the face of the goal. Perhaps if he could just have held it up a bit.
This is Parker. Now it's Staunton. Kevin Richardson is well forward in this attack. Here's York. Well, they don't seem to get forward. Yeah, they might now. York again. Good run by Dwight York. And he scored out of nothing. Beautifully taken, and Swindon are stunned. 39 minutes, and against the run of play, Aston Villa produce a goal. And it's Dwight York who bent his shot round number five, Calderwood. I rather think, Trevor, that Nicky Hammond may have been unsighted.
He was unsighted, but for the first time, Dwight York dropped deeper, got the ball, and was able to run at defenders, which he hadn't been able to do for the first 30 minutes. And suddenly, that little bit of extra skill, hit it with the outside of his foot, and to be fair to the goalkeeper, Nicky Hammond, I don't think he had a lot of chance there with the wind assisted right into the corner. How often do you see a side dominate, have the better chances for 35, 40 minutes, and then let in what is relatively a soft goal because they've denied them any scoring opportunities and suddenly find themselves one down, and the chins will be a bit down when they go in as well at half-time.
It's York, the top scorers, 15th of the season. 5 minutes left in the first half. Calderwood. And the referee blows for half time, and the cheer comes from the Aston Villa corner of the county ground, because Dwight York's goal against the run of play gives the first division team the advantage that they were going to be denied, it seemed, in the first half hour when Swindon had nearly all the play and created some good chances. But it's goals that count, and at half time at the county ground in the FA Cup fifth round, it's Swindon Town 0, Aston Villa 1.
I'm sure you'll know by now, though, why so many people are fans of the way Swindon play football, but there ain't no justice, really, Alan.
Well, Swindon have been terrific in the first half. Aston Villa have got out of jail. They could have been 2-0 down and on their way out of the cup. Ling and Hazard have been fantastic in the middle of the park, but Aston Villa have not picked them up at all. They've let them run the play, dictate the play. As I said, they could have been 2-0 up quite easily. But the problem they've got now, obviously, is they've played so well in the first half and they're going in 1-0 down.
Shows you can buy a player for £15,000, Martin Ling.
Great skill, great running ability, great passer. Mm-hmm. He's been fabulous in the first half.
But 0-1, Jim.
You can buy a lot for £15,000 that can't play as well.
As I think you've proved once or twice.
What I was thinking, that if it is on the cards for Swindon to get to Wembley, you could almost guarantee a first-class game of football. And that's as big a tribute as you can pay them, really, I think, for that half of football. Mm-hmm. It's a delight to watch. And at the moment, it is a travesty of justice, the one goal. But you were predicting it almost before it happened.
I had a feeling in my water, as it were, that
it was a sleepy sort of start to it, really. Dwight York got it. He didn't seem to be moving that well, but it was enough just to make the room. There's the lunging foot. There was just a deflection, I thought, there, off the defender. I think it did move to the right, which really excuses Hammond. He saw it late anyway, which was part of it. We don't get the same angle, but we see he got enough power there into the shot to make it difficult to deal with anyway. And there's the keeper. He's in the centre of the goal. The ball was moved just a yard to the right.
And we hadn't seen much of Dwight York up till that point.
Dwight York had appeared to have some difficulty in getting into the game. And as I say, we feel unhappy about it because we do like a bit of justice, and let's hope that it'll be put right in the second half.
Now, the man perhaps responsible for getting Swindon to play such attractive football here in the first place is Ozzy Ardiles, and he's here now with Ray Stubbs.
Ozzy, the way Swindon played in the first half, they're going to be very disappointed at going in a goal down.
Well, yes, football is a very cruel game sometimes. I believe that Swindon played an extremely good first half, but somehow they didn't take the chances, and obviously at the end of the nearly at the end of the first 45 minutes, Aston Villa nicked.
If you were Glenn Hoddle, what would you be saying now?
I would say to the boys to carry on playing in the way that they have been playing. They are finding a lot of space in midfield, and if they carry on believing in themselves, they are going to have chances in the second half, and hopefully they are going to put the ball in the net.
If you were Ron Atkinson, what would you be saying to your players?
I think they will have to. In a lot of ways, I believe Aston Villa have been overplayed this first 45 minutes. So, obviously, from Aston Villa point of view, they will have to put a lot of more pressure in midfield, especially.
It's great the way Swindon play football, attempt to take the game, isn't it?
It's absolutely great, yes. It's, in fact, it's a pleasure to see Swindon play, yes.
Can I ask you any news on whether you'll be going back into football soon?
Well, that's too early to say, but obviously I am looking to go back into football, but at the moment it's too early to say.
It must be very disappointing having worked so hard at Newcastle.
Well, yes, it is disappointing. I spent a long time there. I was very happy there, and I believe that we were building for the future, but suddenly it happened what it happened, so it's gone.
Those two together at Spurs, with Mick Hazard, who's on the pitch for Swindon today. So the second half, Swindon playing left to right. Kevin Richardson, the Villa captain. Forward by Teal. Here's Yorke. Feels for handball, and that's been given. We'll see what part the wind has to play now in the second half, now that the teams have changed round. Here's Regis. McGrath.
Swindon have a few long-range shots, didn't they, in the first half, but now with the wind behind them, they might be better set to keep trying it. But again, I think to get them back into the game, a feature of their play has been the two full-backs, Bowden and Kerslake, like to get forward. But they haven't had much opportunity. I mean, we had one good run from Kerslake in the corner in the first half, but Bowden hasn't been able to get to the byline. And the longer this half goes on, if it stays 1-0, they'll have to take the chance of getting forward. Although, of course, Glenn Hoddle has got the unpredictable skill of Fitzroy Simpson on the bench as well.
Yes, I'm pretty certain we'll see Simpson if Swindon don't equalise early in the half. He's an exciting player, one that's being pursued by other clubs at the moment, but he lost his place through suspension initially, hasn't got it back. The other Swindon sub is Nicky Somerby, the son of Mike Somerby, who started his career here, of course. There's Fitzroy Simpson. And there's... He looks a bit like his dad, doesn't he, Somerby? Regis. And now Parker. Dwight Yorke just holding his run well. Tony Daly was the target. This is Taylor. And lots going to depend now on whether Hazard can purvey the ball around and dictate the game in the middle of the field. He's found Ling, who had a terrific first half, number four. Villa appealing for hands against him, not given. This is Hazard. Shearer. And it's still Hazard. Foul given against Staunton, quickly taken. This is Jones. Mitchell in the middle. Bowden comes forward from the full-back position to get the header in. Ling. And now it's Jones. Oh, give me the way. Regis. Now York's got Froggatt steaming up on the left. Here he is, number 11. Regis in the penalty area being joined by Daly. Oh, and Regis didn't jump, and Taylor did.
That was the classic counter-attack, because the reason they got Froggatt in down the left there was, of course, Kerslake had made the run in for the attack to give the width to Swindon. When it does break down like that, that's when you capitalise on the stake, the sort of space in that corner. And they nearly conceded a second goal.
Well, now Froggatt has gone across to take the corner, and McGrath and Staunton are lined up in there. Goes Staunton, McGrath as far away as Richardson. It can go back again to Froggatt, and Dwight Yorke with the goalkeeper, and Regis poised, and Swindon get the ball away. Froggatt settling down nicely in the First Division and FA Cup scene. Well played, Hazard. He cost a bit of money in his day. Jones. Foden. Ling. Mitchell. Oh, couldn't edge it on to Ling. It was Teal who was in the way. Kerslake. Still Kerslake. Oh, it's Shearer, and it's wide.
Good play by Kerslake. There he is, jogging back. Comes inside, Staunton gets a toe-ender, and Shearer, instinctively stretching, could have flown in the net, just pulled it across the face of the goal. You'd have to say it was a good chance, but only 9 or 10 yards out. And although he was challenged and stretching, somebody who's got 18 league goals and 28 league goals in all this season, I think he'd be disappointed.
Here he goes again. It's Shearer with Seeley coming out. I think only Aldridge has scored more goals this season than Shearer. And he was so keen to impress today. I saw him at Chelsea in midweek watching a game, and he was saying he hoped that the Swindon lads wouldn't freeze in front of the cameras. Well, they haven't done that. But so far, they've had little luck. And they... Now force the pace on the left-hand side with Bodin taking the throw. Here's Ling. Bodin again. Header by McGrath. Shearer again. Hazard. Wide to Kerslake. And they knew, or Staunton knew, which way Kerslake was going to go there. But the momentum at the moment is with Swindon. This is Jones. Hazard. Still, oh, Shearer was waiting for the ball to come to him, and it was McGrath. And this is the kind of counter-attack where Villa could be dangerous. It's Tony Daly, and he skipped round Sean Taylor, and Regis is in the middle, and so is Yorke, and Daly shoots, and shoots wide. So should he have crossed?
Just a bit, dear. I mean, he's done so well. Again, Swindon just caught with Ben forward. He skips past the first tackle. Now he's got plenty of time to have a look up here. Bowden is trying to get back. And really, if you're going to shoot, you've got to shoot to the far post. You see Cyril Regis coming in there, could easily have got the touch. He'll be disappointed, but annoyed more than anything will be Cyril Regis. I'd like to be on the dressing room, see what he says.
Jones, Mitchell, Shearer far post. Swindon come again. Still Mitchell. Hazard. Jones doing well again. This is Kerslake. It's too long. I think Shearer was looking round, thinking Bowden might have crept up from left back, but he hadn't then. This is Daly. Taylor. Mitchell. Uh-oh. Caught by Staunton. It won't be a red card because Teal was behind Staunton. He wasn't the last man. It wouldn't have been a goal-scoring opportunity. But it was a trip on David Mitchell. 10 minutes gone in the second half. I mean, you've got to book him for that. Yellow card, Staunton. Now, Calderwood is up on the far side. Taylor has gone to join him there.
Yeah.
Hazard to Kerslake, and it comes off Staunton. Mick Hazard claimed the handball, in fact it's a corner. Now last week against Brighton, Swindon got great joy from their set plays at this end of the pitch. Calderwood is a man to watch. But Villa knew who was marking who there, it was effective, and this is Daly. Parker, Yorke, Regis. Taylor gets a foot in, tries to charge on again. Oh, good play by Sean Taylor. The 60-40 against him, but he won it. And the ball played through for Mitchell, and McGrath gets a foot there.
Just beginning to get a bit more incisive with those last passes, Swindon. You just feel a little sense that they feel they've got a chance now. One or two little half openings starting to occur.
Determined play by number six, Taylor, in the build-up. He's now gone up for the corner. It's played back to Bowden. Whisked in. Shearer's header!
Game, good worked corner, laid it back, good first time cross. Just got the faintest of touches, Shearer. Just coming in at the far post, I think we'd have got an offside decision here.
This is Hazard. Looking right and left, waiting for somebody to make a run. Nobody really helped him out there. He had to play it short. McLaren. Swung it wide for Kerslake. Ling. McLaren. Hazard. McLaren, Shearer, blocked by Paul McGrath. It's all Swindon again, isn't it? They've been on top for nearly the whole game. Jones. McLaren. But Seeley, who distinguished himself with that save in the first half from Mitchell, is having a good day. McLaren. Ling. Put that back nicely. Here's Kerslake. Back heel was by Richardson. Froggatt. Uh-oh, we've got trouble here. It's Yorke. And Regis, if he makes ground on the far side, can have an open run here. But it's still Yorke. And still Dwight Yorke, and he lost his balance. This is Parker, and now it's Froggatt. And there's the shot, and what a goal by the 18-year-old, Stephen Froggatt. Well, if Yorke hadn't made a mess of it, we would have been denied that superb goal after 63 minutes. Steve Froggatt, only 18. We'll remember this cup tie. Look at that, a left-foot shot, like an arrow in the top corner, past Nicky Hammond. It's 2-0 to Aston Villa. What do you make of that, Trevor?
Well, it's a quite magnificent strike. I mean, you've got the camera just as soon as it left his foot, it was a goal. And for an 18-year-old, he's got very talented left foot. We've seen him in a few games, haven't we? But to start scoring goals like that, you can understand why Ron Atkinson has had to accommodate him in the side by sort of switching Yorke and Daly in turn up front, but a magnificent goal. Just as it seemed, Dwight Yorke had missed a golden opportunity to go 2-0.
It's his first goal for Aston Villa, Steve Froggatt, and he'll never forget it, will he? He's a candidate for goal of the season. This is Kerslake. Hazard. And away by McGrath. Richardson. Now this has given Aston Villa a grip on the game, which is a first division team they should not lose. That's Teal. Jones, Hazard. Uh-oh, Regis. This is where Swindon lose the ball and then get caught out. It's Daly on the right. Support coming up from three other players here for Villa. Still Daly, Regis.
Shearer. Hazard. McLaren. They're just trying to hold their position so as not to go offside. Kerslake. Jones. Mitchell's there. McGrath. It's two against one here. Calderwood had to win it. Kerslake. Shearer. Here's Hazard. Quarter of an hour to go. Can he get Bowden in here? Mitchell! And Swindon are back in it. And they've scored at last. David Mitchell puts Glenn Hoddle's team back in with a shout in the cup tie. And the system worked there for Swindon. They got down the left-hand side with Bowden drilled across, and Mitchell really had an easy finish. It's 2-1.
That's a marvellous pass from Hazard. What a cross that is. Look, inch perfect. And Mitchell, that is one, a dream one for a striker on a plate. And I think we might have an exciting run up to the final whistle. The first time, perhaps, Tony Daly hasn't worked back with Bowden. He got 2 or 3 yards on him. And again, there might be a word about that after the match.
I'll tell you what, this has become a really good game, hasn't it, eh? Swindon deserved the goal for what they did in the first half. And it's now 2-1, and anything can happen. And that's just what you want from a cup tie. The second division team didn't let their supporters down. They kept plugging away, and they got their reward. Big Mitchell was in the right place. And Ron Atkinson now faces an anxious few minutes, perhaps. Froggatt. Shearer, well, could they come and equalise? Ling. And now Mitchell's out left. Fitzroy Simpson in support. Kubicki obstructed him. Free kick. Calderwood makes his way forward. So does Sean Taylor. Chances here then for Swindon. The whole ground is lifted now. There's Taylor with the header back, Ling with the header in. Mitchell's in there, himself with the overhead kick. And there'll be the trainer needed because two Villa players seem to collide there. So the Swindon physio, Kevin Morris, is coming on as well. I think this happened when Sean Taylor headed the ball back across goal, and you'll see Mitchell in a minute go for an overhead kick, but it's there, the two challengers, Teal and McGrath on Shearer, and the two Villa players got hurt. Good wholehearted football here. Nice mix of the two styles. And a fine cup tie has resulted. Here's Teal. Taylor taking up the near side position on the 6-yard line. He's in the middle of that crowd of players. It's back again with Kerslake. Header out by Regis. McLaren shot, hit Kevin Richardson. That's a corner. Corner to Swindon. Taylor and Mitchell facing the kicker. Header by McGrath again. Daly.
Ling. McLaren. Back in by Kerslake. And the flick on almost worked. Bowden. Little flick in. Oh, it was meant for Taylor. Here's Bowden again. Was he brought down? 3 minutes to go. And it was a careless place to give away a free kick. Can Swindon equalise? Bowden and Hazard over the ball. Here's Taylor. It's out. It's out. It's a goal kick.
They just tried to vary it a bit and go beyond the far post. But with the swirly wind, just took it a little bit too far. Sean Taylor couldn't get to it before it went behind the byline. And Les Seeley, not surprisingly, taking his time for this kick.
Just over a couple of minutes to go. Froggatt. Regis Richardson. Oh, we're going to go back now. Wonder what would happen if FIFA ever banned the back pass of the goalkeeper. We'd have some football then, wouldn't we?
Hey, would you? Might also get some wellies into the stand as well as players panic. Realise they can't pass it back and have to get rid of the ball pretty quick.
Yeah, wouldn't solve the problem. Here's Parker. Good ball to Staunton. We're into the third minute of stoppage time. Aston Villa are in the quarter-finals of the FA Cup. Ron Atkinson and Andy Gray see their side defeat second division Swindon thanks to partially a goal from Steve Froggatt on 63 minutes that made it 2-0 and pushed the tie that little bit further away from Swindon. Although they got a goal back, just look at the celebrations there. Les Seeley letting his hair down as they go over to the supporters. Although Swindon got a goal back through Mitchell 15 minutes from the end, it wasn't enough on the day. Glenn Hoddle's team did him proud, especially in the first half. And Trevor Brooking, that was a gripping cup tie for the spectator.
Well, I was very excited. I think you have to say Stephen Froggatt's shot was one of the best you're likely to see. I mean, he has got a super left foot, but to hit one like that, and from the minute he's left his boot, it was a goal. And certainly any goal like that perhaps deserves to win a cup tie. But Villa were not at their best, I didn't feel, today. Swindon had long spells when they were the better side, perhaps just missing out on the last incisive pass, that was all. But they did themselves credit, and but in the end, it's Villa in the hat.
Well, certainly Froggatt's picture will be in the papers tomorrow. Only 18, his first senior goal. What a day to remember for him, and the Aston Villa supporters will be looking forward now, as we are, to the draw for the sixth round in a few minutes, because their team are safely through. And the First Division seems to have restored the order of the FA Cup this weekend. And I believe Ray Stubbs is waiting in the tunnel with one of the victorious.
Well, that wasn't easy, was it?
Well, yeah, it was a very difficult game for us. And eventually we get through the game and came out on top. It was just delightful to get the result in the end.
And you got a goal just when it mattered.
Yes, at the time we were hanging on 1-0, the first goal. Of course, they had a nice ball into to my area, just taking on the defender. Dummy him at first, he went for the dummy, and then a good shot, give the keeper no chance really, and it's just delightful to see it going in at the end.
What did your manager say at half time?
Well, he just said to us, pick up the tempo a bit, because they at the time was the better team. And as I said, the goal seems to be the turning point for us. And at the second half, we just get the second goal, which was enough to get the result in the end.
And here's the score of the second goal there. Stephen Froggatt, what a strike that was.
I don't think I'll hit a better one than that in my career. I mean, I'm just, you know, really pleased that we're in the next round of the cup.
Really, just at that time, Swindon looked like they were coming back at you again.
Yeah, obviously, I mean, they did put us under a hell of a lot of pressure. And half-time, the boss wasn't too happy with the way we were performing. But I think in the second half, we battled a lot more. And, well, we're through. That's all that matters, I suppose, now.
Congratulations, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
The two scorers that put Aston Villa into that sixth-round draw coming up in a few minutes' time. The day, Jimmy, when the counter-punchers beat the Boxers.
Yes, yes. You've got to, I suppose, admire Villa's resilience in the end to take that amount of punishment and still, you know, somehow snatch the game. But it was a brilliant goal, you know, absolutely fantastic goal that ended up as being the winning goal of the game.
Yeah. Well, you've done well to hold your concentration there because a few yobs are throwing stones at the window, but you've got to expect it sometimes. Alan? Yeah.
Yes, I mean, this was a fantastic goal that Froggatt hits into the back of the net. A super goal. Swindon were unlucky, but they played exceptionally well. But when you play as well as that, luck shouldn't come into it. They always look to me like they'll concede goals. Mm-hmm. And they played superb on the day. Hazard was magnificent. They played great football. They were a credit to themselves and their supporters. Villa didn't play well on the day, and I thought they were lucky to get through.
Richardson, the Villa captain, is with us. Let's hear from him.
Well, reaction to the draw, Kevin?
Great, great draw for us. We've had a hard round so far in the cup, and we've got another one. We'll have a pool of switch, but you know, we've done well today, and we're looking forward going to either place. We've got a fancy with chances now.
You don't mind going to Portman Road or Anfield and getting a good result?
Yeah, we've done it at Swindon, Derby, and Tottenham. Why not Anfield or Portman Road?
Great character today.
Yeah, we had to. Swindon played very well. Some lovely football. They give us a lot of pressure and a lot of problems, but our lads battled well and I would think deservedly went into the next round.
Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
So, good match here today and a good draw. I've had a postcard from a Mr. Terry Cridland, who comes from Ashford in Kent, who tells me that he spotted what you've been doing, incidentally, for the last week or so. He spotted you out there.
Spotted me doing what?
Out there. You've been there. How did you get the? Where did you get the suit from? That's what...
Listen, I'm not taking this lying down. I think that man's impersonating me. Who is he?
I don't know. But we want to know, if you're doing the singles, why you don't do the doubles in a loop.
Wife wouldn't let me.
Last thought or two on today's.
Really, a wonderful cup tie. Yeah. Had everything about it. Courage as well. That three players going for that header, blood all over the place. Fought out, massive amount of skill in the game. You know, drama as well. Couldn't ask for any more. And if the rest of the ties are like that on the way to Wembley, we're not going to grumble.
Yes, absolutely super. I hope you've enjoyed it at home. You now know why people like watching Swindon play. But Aston Villa did the trick here today. You've seen the draw, so there's lots more to come on the road to Wembley with BBC Television. We certainly hope you enjoyed this, and you'll enjoy a lot more with us. From us, it's goodbye.